We have all heard the story of Adam and Eve and the Garden of Eden. And with a little variation, the story is similar in the Abrahamic scriptures and the Middle Eastern mythologies. But what many people don't know is that before Eve, there was another woman called Lilith. The fascinating thing is that unlike Eve, Lilith was fashioned from clay, just like Adam. Now, since she was created like Adam, she refused to submit to her husband's commands. After that, she was given an option, either submit to her husband or leave the Garden of Eden. Lilith was not willing to give up her independence, so she left the Garden of Eden and settled near the Red Sea. After Lilith left, seeing that Adam was feeling lonely, God decided to create a new woman for him, called Eve. Eve was fashioned from one of Adam's ribs while he was sleeping. The rib was taken from near the heart so as to symbolize equality, love and affection. It was not taken from above the head so as to symbolize man's inferiority, nor was it taken from near the foot so as to symbolize superiority. Now, as Adam and Eve were enjoying their time in Eden, God sent angels in an attempt to convince Lilith to come back to Eden. But she refused to come, and seeing that she turned her back on the Creator, Lilith was demonized. She was now considered a serpent-shaped demon. When she learned of the happy life Adam and Eve were living, Lilith decided to take revenge and assume the shape of a serpent. She then tricked Eve, forcing her and Adam to taste the forbidden fruit, which caused the couple to be expelled from paradise. The myth of Lilith is found in Hebrew, Sumerian, Babylonian, and Assyrian mythologies. The legend of Lilith in Mesopotamia was seen as an evil deity, or when associated with the moon, she is regarded as a goddess having different phases and moods. That's why she could be seen as a fertility goddess or a devilish figure. Theories state that the absence of Lilith was created in the Bibles because an independent strong woman figure like Lilith would go against the patriarchal structure of the Judeo-Christian culture. Due to this, she is embraced by the feminist movement and is often regarded as the first true feminist who only wanted equality. The movement claims that Lilith was unfairly demonized like most women in history who have defied the unjust patriarchy. Now, the story of Lilith may or may not be true, however, her story does represent a lot of real-life women who have undergone a similar demonization. Many of these women are from the medieval times. Their story is very similar and it goes something along the following lines. A talented woman works to better society, living her peaceful life. Some evil people try to take credit for her work or try leg-pulling to one-up her. If it works, they are successful. If it does not work, they demonize her, in which case they are also successful. Many women have been burnt alive or lynched following a similar pattern in their lives. The patriarchal societies have always been fearful of an independent woman like Lilith. If you like this video, please like and share. If you are new to this channel, hit that subscribe button. Enjoy the outro and I'll see you guys in the next episode.